from your hairstylist to your housekeeper, your daycare provider to your dog walker, these people are making your lives easier all year round. And during the holiday season, we want to say a special thank you with a special tip.
We do. I had to chuckle because I wish I had a housekeeper. But
that's on my list.
Who's tipping me for scrubbing that toilet, okay? But on the holidays, how much do you give? Local financial professional Megan Clark from Clark & Associates joins us with her guide, True Gratuity. And we don't want to be this too gratuitous. Don't scare me here. But, you know, I mean, there's certain things you tip throughout the year always, but then maybe around the holidays it's supposed to be a little extra special than just the average. Yeah?
Yeah, so we want to tip people that we use all the time in our daily lives. So whether we have a nanny, and whether it's the newspaper delivery man, the FedEx guy, we want to go that extra mile during this time of year just to show them our gratitude and appreciation. Gratuity is kind of a dying art, and it's a great thing to even just write a handwritten card if your budget won't allow for a dollar amount.
Very interesting. And so I think people get a lot of anxiety because they just don't know how much is appropriate. You don't want to offend someone. And as you said, everybody has a different budget. So are there parameters? What should we be looking for in terms of how much we're tipping?
Yeah, so Emily Post is a great etiquette guide to reference and go to during this time of year and any questions like that. So whether it's your dog walker that you use throughout the year, you know, giving him an extra, him or her an extra $15 during the holiday season. If you're eating out at a restaurant, a great thing to do is to tip an extra percentage amount. So typically during the year, we tip 15 to 20%. Mm-hmm. And during the holiday season, we want to increase that to 20 to 25% mm-hmm. as an average. And then also a great one is your FedEx delivery guy. A lot of us are shopping a lot more online. They're delivering a lot more packages. And so having a little card ready with a tip inside of it to give to him would be a great practice to say thank you.
You're still looking for yours from your family members, right?
So, yeah, so you're trying to mention that some of the people that maybe we don't normally tip that maybe we should be, including, like you said, the delivery folks. I mean, we say FedEx, I assume UPS as well, or the regular postman. We talked about the newspaper because I do actually get a card from the gentleman that delivers my paper to my house every day. So, you know, I was looking through that, trying to figure out what's appropriate. Is there anyone else we're missing? Maybe you can tell us. You mentioned the servers. Is there anyone else we could be missing?
Definitely. And for your newspaper delivery guy, the average is between $15 to $25 to tip, whatever you feel comfortable with.
Okay.
But make sure it's within your budget. You don't want to blow through your budget this time of year. It's really important to stay on task and on track with that, especially if you have a significant other or partner or spouse. Make sure you're checking in with them and saying, what is our tipping budget? And making sure you're on the same page. It's a great kind of tool to use to get on the same page with your significant other. So as far as tipping other people, you definitely, again, want to tip your hairstylist, your barber, and when you're going out to eat. Let's say you're out at a store and you want to get a big TV and it's big and heavy and that person's helping you put that in your car. They probably are making about $10 an hour, so go ahead and give them $10. That will make their day. They'll be very appreciative of that.
I do notice, though, sometimes at certain stores, I've tried doing that actually, but they've helped you, and they've told me that they're not allowed to accept money sometimes. So
yeah.
I've done that a few times where they've helped me, and they're like, no, I can't. I'm like, no, take it, you know?
Yeah, based on company policy or sometimes even different industries, they can't actually legally accept gifts. In our wealth management firm, we're not allowed to accept cash gifts. So a lot of our clients bring in baked goods. You know, one client brought in a Christmas tree and we decorated our office with it. So there's lots of different ways you can give without it being monetary. And like I said, you know, even a homemade gift, if you have a child and you have a babysitter, there's nothing more precious than something homemade from a child. So
I mean, a macaroni necklace goes a long way.
It does.
Absolutely. People are touched by that. It's really about just showing your appreciation.
It is. A handwritten thank you card is really just goes a million miles. So it's really great.
All right, let's talk about people who maybe we should not tip. Is it inappropriate sometimes to tip certain people?
Yeah, that's a good point.
I'm thinking like your employer, you certainly wouldn't want to be giving a monetary donation, but maybe perhaps a gift or something or a card of appreciation.
Yeah, if you have a boss, you know, whether it's a bottle of wine or just you know, something for them to you know, enjoy with their family at home, those are definitely great gifts. You definitely don't want to give a monetary tip in that situation. There's no, you know, other than someone saying I can't accept it, like your postal man, your USPS guy, they're actually legally not supposed to accept cash, money, or gift cards. So what we did growing up is my dad, our family, we always baked something, wrote a handwritten card, and took it down and hand-delivered it to the you know, USPS guy.
Okay. So,
yeah. Or lady.
Okay. Where can we find more information if we want to kind of follow up that, if our viewers want to know more?
Yeah, so right on our website, clarkfinancialplanning.com, we have a holiday tipping guide. There's also another link on our website for building a budget. In case you need that service, it's free of charge on there. But the tipping guide is on there, and you can, it references CNN tipping guide as well as Emily Post. So.
All right. Yeah. Megan Clark, we thank you very much from Clark & Associates. Happy holidays to you.
Thank you very much. Thank you for having us.
I feel a little bit better now. Now I know what to do. If it doesn't work out, I'm coming back to see you.